side. Also, why does it have a bat? It's Gumshoe. It's basically like his state of mind, I guess. Must be wine. It's just sugar color. A little bit of dye here and there. Is this another piece of the evidence in the case? You know, I never did care for the word tag. It's confusing. So confused about that. Do you know how many other words sound like tag? Like bag? Like it? Bag, gag, nag, lag, ags? Ags? Is that a word? You challenge me? Are we playing a word game now? Are you challenging me? Do you know what I will do to you? Do you have any idea what I will do to you? Alright, we're just examining the evidence here. She put her name on it. Emma Sky, don't tell me you bring this with you everywhere you go. Well, you never know where something might go down. What kind of world do you think we live in? Well, when you think about it, what sort of world where you, like, you have a 3-day trial and then you execute somebody? She's not in the wrong here, buddy. I'm looking at this going like, I have no idea. What about the blood on this? Okay. You can't open the locks if your fingerprint doesn't match. If you can open it, they'll give you 50 cents. Wait, what? No, the police department lacks faith in its lock system. After all, Detective Goodman was stabbed here after opening his locker. No, wait. Yeah, he does. No, he does have his jacket on. Somehow I thought he had didn't have his jacket on. But at the same time, he was found dead over at the prosecutor's office. So the reason why the victim's shoe has blood on the sole is because he was murdered here and then transferred. Okay, that makes sense. But what are we missing to progress to the hearing? Right. Yeah, this is... I was kind of hoping maybe he'd tell me his? And we still can't talk to Edgeworth. Which is a bummer. My crowning achievement, my masterpiece, you might say. But, that is always misunderstood, pal. Art. He was dancing proudly on the day of the awards ceremony. But there was a lot of people coming and going after the ceremony. They took the blue badge away for a while.
Really? Why?
They said it was shameful or something like that. Shameful? I told night and day.
Empathize with Detective Gumshoe. To see why they moved it.
Hey, that's it! That's the King of Prosecutors Award that Mr. Edgeworth got the other day.
Were you at the award ceremony, Detective Gumshoe?
Of course, pal. I got an award for diligence myself.
Ah, congratulations. Wondering why the shield of... The shield? Why is it broken?
There's a reason. I'll tell you what it is later.
Apparently he's forgotten.
And apparently he couldn't seem to be figured out in the time that he's forgotten.
We asked him before, and I was kind of hoping he'd remember, but okay, sure, why not? Okay, so we have... Edgeworth is still not being removed.
was in with a inquiry. We talked everything about you.
Must be one of the detectives. Mumbling something to himself. Oh, the killer used a cassette tape. Ah, a crafty trick. That gunshot was a fake. Please, this is good. No one will accept a cassette tape in this day and age.
He's not writing a report. He's writing a novel.
Okay.
Detective desks. There are computers and things. Okay. All right.
Meekins, I feel like I've exhausted everything from you, buddy. Well, hang on. No idea what that is. You apparently have... He's never been in... Okay, he's never been really in the evidence room looking at anything in the evidence room.
He not know you have to sign in to go into the evidence room, right? How did you get into the evidence room if you didn't log in your ID?
Look at the guide of the game. True.
You said you wanted some hot tea, right?
Oh, no, but thanks. Did she even look at me?
Okay, so this is... Damn it. Okay, this is all just hot tea. Okay, I'm kind of... I'm dangling here by a wire. Can't actually interact with that. I love how it's like, it's a thing. Okay. Nope.
But I know we have to talk to Miles, but I can't seem to figure out how to get Miles to appear. And I'm like, I'm stuck here.
Oh crap, I meant to examine.
Hello.
This blood must be from when Lana. No, my sister isn't the murderer. But she did call you, didn't she? Time of the crime. And her right hand is bandaged. Just whose side are you on?
This has nothing to do with taking sides. It's that Lana's hand had blood on it during the call.
Well, yeah, but did it have her blood?
Or somebody else's blood?
Okay, we're doing checks. Little pups, good officers end up not being so not innocent.
I think Meekins is without a doubt fine. Like, I think he's a good boy, but.
Dude, Edgeworth, where are you, buddy? There's gotta be a trigger.
I'm just checking his room.
I don't know where to go.
It's weird. Early on, we had a little bit of trouble, and then the game started getting its stride. And the last trial that we had right before this, everything kind of fit into play. Like, there was a little bit like, I'm not too sure where to go. But for the vast majority, it was like, okay, this is it. This final chapter kind of feels more shoehorned in.
You know what I mean? Like, they had a very narrow idea, like, where you need to go, when you need to go, and if you don't do that in the exact order, you're not gonna get it.
Real quick. There's no blood anywhere?
And you won't let me take a look at the,
There's 8 cameras in the evidence room and all. One for each section.
Which monitor shows the section where the crime took place?
Why do cattle sit before the ring? Not for men to know.
Unless you're the security guard responsible. I'm sorry, did you just wash your, like, wave your hand away in terms of doing the evidence? Well, we already gave him food to keep him happy.
Maybe using his steed?
Maybe.
Bulky equipment is gathering dust. Sort of started looking cool is this. That's my personal pole.
I never get around to using it.
Wait, I've seen that somewhere before.
Hey, right, pal, that's the metal detector. Not the one that led to the solving of that case on Gord Lake, remember?
Alright, wow, that feels like ages ago. And, I don't think I've seen this one before.
Oh, that's a bug suit. Sure will come in handy in solving some case sooner or later.
Cheap-looking box?
Hey, you can't judge a person by a machine by the cover. You gotta look at the heart.
Okay. Remember that shit. Look at the heart of a bug zapper. You will know. Hold on. Is there anything on the door, I wonder? Nope. Okay. Just checking. Maybe using his seat as a mini. Little mini coup. I have examined everything here. Okay. Crap. Can we do enough of that? Are you kidding? Are you joking me, game?
That's been one massive pool of blood. Never seen anything like that. Not a professional. What's your opinion, detective?
Pale blue blood. Maybe Detective Gunman? It was actually an alien.
This proves that something really happened in front of this locker. Make a note of it on the floor plans.
Hey, if you don't want my opinion, you shouldn't have asked, okay?
Please don't tell me that was it. Please don't tell me that was like, that was the only thing I needed because like,
Well, that's either when you got finished off or that's actually where the murder was originally committed, right?
So,
I mean, you noted that in the log.
Yes.
Yeah, the poo.
Okay, so apparently he knows nothing about the case that he currently is in. Okay. Oh my god.
I don't know what to do.
Miles, are you out of Edgeworth? Edgy baby. Please tell me, are you out?
Damn it!
One of two things. If he was stabbed and actually tried to get away, put his hand there, that could be a thing, right? Like, he was trying to get away, but there should also be blood spatter going along the ground. Because that's a lot of blood. Or, Megan's right hand and Sky's right hand
Well, Negan's left hand and Sky's right hand got injured. Negan's, it would have to be like this versus like this. So it was the right hand. So why did Negan's hand get hurt? Two, if Sky did actually kill him, she left the handprint there, proceeded to then grab the body, walk it out somehow, and throw it into a trunk. There's so many, like, I don't... Yeah, no idea. Yeah. Sure. Hang on, let me, I got an idea. Uno momento, chat. Okay, is it gonna hurt? What am I missing? I am missing something. What am I missing? Good news. One more investigation after this, I guess. Okay, got that. Okay. 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 You gotta be shitting me. Oh, you gotta be kidding me. Oh, why? You wanna see the thing that we apparently missed? That was it. Yep. Found in Mr. Edgeworth's car, stabbed with Mr. Edgeworth's knife. I think from now on, if I have no idea how to proceed, I'll just start throwing evidence at all of them. The weird thing is, just a little side thing here. I've shown this knife to him twice. But it's this time that it will trigger the plot to move forward. I love Ace. I love Wrights. I love the characters in this game. But some of the, like, restrictive issues in this game, I get maybe it's a DS thing. Maybe handheld games are like this. But, like, hot damn! Oh, biscuits. What would drive Chief Brodsky to Sky to do such a thing? I didn't mean that. I'm sure. Of course, she really did. Someone who must have grudged against Miss Edgeworth. All right, real quick, I'm gonna do the other knife now. Detective Gizmond's known the switchblade knife. I bet Edgeworth was the most surprised of anyone because of the SL9 connection. And that was Mr. Edgeworth's worst big case, you know, 2 years ago. That was the first time the world knew Edgeworth was a man in beard. But why would evidence from that case turn up now? I guess it's not over, pal. Maybe there's some loose ends left on that case. Okay, well. And that was a bloody violent case. Violent? So it was a murder. Serial killing? Maybe I don't want to get involved in this after all. But the killer made a mistake, and Mr. Edgeworth built his case around that to nab him. And that was 2 years ago? That put Mr. Edgeworth right in the spotlight. Started the rumor mill. Rumors about forged evidence? It was supposed to be all cleaned up with the transfer the other day. Last job he ever did. Detective Goodman, that is. What do you mean? The Detective Goodman was the detective in charge of the SL9 incident. Yeah, we know that. We were told that, but... I love how they'll tell you information, but if it's not from the person that is supposed to give you the information, it's just like, nunny? So, the switchblade knife. The victim took the knife out of the evidence locker himself. Okay, so now we should be able to go. Hopefully. What did I miss? Have you got that Narnia sound effect? No. I have not got the Narnia sound effect yet. Did I get any evidence out of that? That I could present? No. Okay, so... Nothing out of him. Okay, what about he was a part of the case as well. So if I give you this. No, he's a stickler on the whole damn thing. Right. That should have triggered. Oh, wow. Are you kidding me, game? Take a look. Take a quick peek then. Shocked as. Okay, so hand left and start spraying. Wait, what? But I did that already. Hold on. Examine. Upper left, right? Examine. They do see the blood on the... Oh! Oh my god! Hey, you guys see that blood spot on the wall?
Sorry, on the lacquer? Yeah?
Man, I wonder where that came from. But you have to deal with a chemical to see that it's actually totally blood and not... like raspberry jelly from breakfast this morning? What? Well, we clicked on it. Hell, he opened it up, Zap. That's the thing. That was right there. That was. Ah! Okay. I knew it. This is someone's right hand print.
What?
What's the matter, detective?
This locker. It's mine!
It's yours.
Please! You have to help me. When they come to take me away, promise you'll testify that it wouldn't harm a fly. You'll do that for me, won't you, pals?
This is an important clue. I'll jot it down on the floor plans.
I'm counting on you guys. Believe me, you can't trust the police.
Yeah, basically. Bam, 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 bam. But you're a detective. Did you guys not hear that? Hang on. Did it actually reset in the routing? There we go. You guys didn't know that was the thinking command. But you're a detective.
Hey, pal, look at the time.
Was there something you need to be doing?
Just that Mr. Edgeworth's inquiry committee should be letting out soon. I'm gonna go give them a report for the day. It might help you, you know.
Report? You mean the note written on the back of that flyer? The one that says nothing but no problems?
Hey, it's Mr. Edgeworth we're talking about. I'm sure he could use a report like this. I believe in him.
He's enemies when you got friends like Detective Gumshoe.
I'm up, pal. Later.
Let's see what Edgeworth has to say about all this.
Yay! You finally do this.
They kept being like, man, you should go talk to Edgeworth. He should be getting out right now. Hey, you should totally go do that. Yeah, he should be getting out right by now.
There is a god.
Oh, yes. My apologies. Oh, it's the bellboy from the original one of the murders. Oh, what's you?
Have we met somewhere?
Huh? Mr. Edgeworth, I beg your leave. So long. Is Edgeworth here? Standing by the window with a teacup in his hand. Right. Ask the hotel bring him tea service?
Mr. Edgeworth, you're back from the district prosecutor's office?
I am. By the way, Detective Gumshoe was looking for you.
Yes. Brought me the latest information, it seems.
Really, was it helpful?
Apparently, a new French restaurant is opening near here.
I think he was trying to console me, somehow.
The real info is on the other side, Edgeworth?
Oh, Miss Edgeworth, I think this whole thing is really taking a toll on him. Okay, so first things first. Boom. Oh, right, I better check this now. As I was saying, what's this? Record ID card use.
Edgeworth, you went into the evidence room that day, didn't you? Just before the incident occurred, no less?
Yes, that's true.
Why, Mr. Edgeworth?
Please don't look at me like that. I was asked to go. By Chief Gant, no less.
Wait a minute. Hypothetical.
Chief Gant is a serial killer, but he gets off on letting the bad guys go. It's all perception.
Chief of Police.
He wanted evidence for a case that wrapped up a half a year ago. He told me he wanted me to keep it here in the prosecutor's office. But it was solved, right? It would have to be in the evidence already, right?
But the chief has never won to clinic.
In any case, on the day of the stabbings, I brought this back here. Can I ask what kind of case it was?
I can't say.
It really has nothing to do with the current case.
I'm curious about this other case.
I'd make a note of it.
As stubborn as always, I told you, this has nothing to do with your current case.
Right, but it kinda does. Right, please. I'm the prosecutor on this case. You don't expect me to sit here and discuss the case with you over a cup of tea.
I'll pass on the tea, just tell me about the case.
Mr. Wright, Mr. Edgeworth, just told you no in a very polite manner.
What side are you on anyway?
I'm just showing my best evidence again the reaction out of him.
Best evidence.
I'm a prosecutor on this case. You don't expect me to sit. Oh, okay. Not my best evidence. Got it.
Best evidence.
Nope. Okay. Best evidence. Oh. Best evidence. Okay, never mind. I'm like reaching again. Actually, hang on, maybe I need to talk to him to then wrap it back around.
So, how'd the inquiry committee go?
Actually, they decided to treat this not as a case of concealing evidence.
This communications error during the investigation.
Concealing evidence?
Yes, apparently there are some who believe that I concealed evidence.
They gave me a warning. Lucky this time. Again.
Again?
I've heard them say that so many times. Ever since that case 2 years ago.
Are you okay for tomorrow's trial?
Well, the presiding prosecuting attorney, however, something happened. They gave control of the investigation over to the police department.
Yes, any further investigation with this case will be directed by the police chief of police camp. I can do nothing but wait for his results. Let's see. Why, I ask, why? All along, I've done only what I believe is right. I have nothing to be ashamed of. Still, I've never seen him this out of sorts. Okay, so I need to kick him in the butt with evidence. Evidence that he has not seen that is damning enough. That's not it. Maybe if I just show him my best evidence, I can get him a reaction out of him. Best evidence, huh? Man, it can't be the gloves, man. It can't be the gloves. Is it the gloves? Nope. Best piece of evidence. Not the glove. Not the ID record. Well, no way. Wait, don't tell me the best piece of evidence was the thing that we just showed, but now it'll give me something to talk about. No. Wait, hang on. Please don't tell me I'm right. Hang on, that didn't open up anything. Okay, cool. Best piece of evidence. Man, maybe I don't have it yet. Nope. It's not the knives. It was the note. It all has to do with that case you were on, the SL9 incident. Some dark suspicion you were wrapped up in. You were the man who revived the worst memory of my life. I'm gonna be telling you about this sooner or later. You talking about father's murder in that elevator? Hey, Edgeworth, why don't you tell me about it? Tell me the truth. Boom? The SL9 incident was a heinous serial killer case. The head of the investigation was deputy chief of police at the time. Damon Gant. Mackie Oldkew was involved at least 2 years ago, too, then. He was a top officer, and it was my first time working. Nervous. You get nervous, too. What I want to know is why was a deputy chief of police on the investigation? In truth, I had to use slightly more extreme methods than normal. We were dealing with a vicious murder. If I let him go, the blood would be on my hands. We won our guilty verdict, and the killer was executed. But you didn't... Of course not. Didn't touch the evidence. Yes, I will do anything in my power to win a trial. However, I do have a code, and I follow it faithfully. By the way, Emma, the prosecutor wanted to know something. What? If you were still studying forensic science? Yes? Just today, Mr. Wright, we're using this. Luminol testing food. Oh, then. I'd have use for this. Aluminium powder for taking fingerprints? Been chemically treated for better adhesion. For me? Are you sure? We are the enemy, you know. I've no say in today's investigation. Do as you will. Maybe he might have been a serial killer. And he might have been covering it up. And then now that he's in a position of power, he can move everything around, right? Edgeworth, I'm really... No need to thank me. Here, take your powder. Fingerprints files for everyone involved. Thanks? How about giving these to the deck of Gunshoe as well? Well, let's get going. Right. Remember seeing a suspicious handprint somewhere. Hark! The game is afoot after fumbling horribly. Well, look at here now, Chad. He gone.
He played with his computer.
The light blinking below the monitor, it says recording. Yes, but I want to see where. Can I get it? Damn it. I can't take the file. Okay. It's not stealing evidence, by the way. It's just borrowing. Investigation turned up a suspicious handprint. Direction 2. Here, and this blood on the detective's evidence locker. Use the secret weapon we just borrowed. Right, let's get started. First, choose a finger. A finger. Each finger leaves behind a slightly different fingerprint imprint. Let's choose the finger that will left clear prints. Well, that looks like the index finger. Can't at a glance tell the difference. But quit procrastinating and choose a finger. I would choose that finger. Okay, now it's time to check for prints. Show you how it's done. Starting to get that sparkle in our eyes. First, we sprinkle the aluminium powder around. How do you do that? With enter. Ah, it's like the trick. Powder adheres completely to the prints. Powder is well spread. Just blow away the excess. How do I do that? With E. Exciting, I know. Imagine you're blowing out the candles on a birthday cake. You know, it's funny because my understanding is you actually don't do that anymore because it could, well, spittle on the fingerprint. If you're going by a fingerprint. Oh, that looks like fun. Am I going to use it? Fine, it won't go to your nose or anything. Just pour the powder on thick and blow away the extra. The basics of fingerprinting. Okay, give it a try. Okay, you did it! You found one! But this looks nothing like a fingerprint. I didn't mention, I guess it doesn't. It looks like a glove, maybe? Am I against the thumb gang? No, but primarily speaking, when you actually put your hand on anything, most people turn their thumb to the side versus turning it flush to the wall or the surface. What does it mean? I think it means we're out of luck. Luck? The person who left this handprint must have worn gloves. Don't tell me we've been wasting our time here. Calm down, it's just the way it goes sometimes with scientific investigations. But it does seem a shame. While we're at it, why don't we look for the other prints? See the locker door closely again. Seems like there are fingerprints outside the bloody handprint as well. It's outside the blood. What do you mean, right there?
Let's get this going.
Hello?
Why is it not triggering? There we go.
Yay, a fingerprint, so it's clear. It's dazzling. Dazzling. Anyway, this print took a lot of effort to find. Mash it up right away. We're not done yet. This is quite a process. Well, there's no point in finding a fingerprint. Not knowing who the owner is, right? Right? Watch, it's Gumshoe. It's gonna be Gumshoe, right? Fingerprint data we got from this stretch. We have to point out the person you think about these prints. We're supposed to know who it was. I can make a pretty good guess. Bloody handprint and the fingerprints are in different places, right? That means that the prints probably don't have anything to do with our case. Whose fingerprints would most likely find on this evidence locker? Well? Comparing. Oh, yeah. Aha! So these prints belong to Detective Gumshoe. Something wrong, Mr. Wright? gave me this so what look. I guess it's probably because I was thinking so what.
it might be the attacker's hand. Yes, they glove, because remember, we only found one glove and one is missing. So the one that is missing is the one that is probably caked in blood.
Okay, so we came up with nothing this time, but there's always next time. Sometimes you hit, sometimes you miss. Gotta roll with the punches. Thanks. Wait. Recruiting. One other handprint. There was. Where we got a luminal field reaction, right? Right. There was a handprint here. Okay. Wanna try it? Yeah?
Going in, champ.
The area with the blood was wiped away, right? You only ended up finding and using chemical means. Any prints in that area will have been wiped away too.
Oh, right. So, no prints?
You say the probability of your hypothesis is high?
Don't ask.
Anyway, we must try to find prints that weren't wiped away. Bloody handprint.
You mean right here?
Ah, looky, looky, looky.
It's weird that out of all the chapters, this is the only chapter we started seeing like more gameplay in it.
And here I was hoping for Damon.
Let's go with Marshall. Oh, what does she know? Marshall? Buddy? What y'all doing here?
These fingerprints, they... Whose are they? Whose? Is it someone I know? Duff's a Marshall. Jake. That's gotta be a coincidence. He's not involved in the crime. Emma? Decidedly different from Detective Gumshoe's prints. Luminal reaction. Blood and the fingerprints are in the same place. We have a Jake Marshall's fingerprints on a white blood stain. But why would Officer Marshall... Looks like our investigation is finally turning up some results. I guess this is what you call decisive evidence? I don't believe it.
Good time, chat.